starting with my NYX brush. Using Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow in the color Ebony. I use my spoolie in first to brush my hairs upwards. Then I lightly tap my brush into the dip. Starting with my tail, I'll outline the bottom of my brow. And I'm being as light-handed as I can be because I don't want it to come out too dark. Then I brush my hairs down so I can outline the top. She love me, but she in California. Wanna be the talk of the town. We're moved to California. Duck off just the fucker so nobody knows in California. By the beach and women, it's so plenty. They need marijuana. It's so good head and you tell them turn their phone off. Tell them get so loose, then we catch them with their shirt off. Girl, take that skirt off. Now put on your work clothes and baby, put that guard down. We gon' piss the neighbors off. Then I gotta go, girl, and catch you at your dead job. Keep it all discreet, then I meet you when it's nighttime. You smell like the summertime. Find a dinner glass of wine. You know that I. Then I brush my hairs back in place and fix any lines if I need to. Then I repeat the same steps with the other brow. All right, so now I'm tapping my brush into the dip again. And to fill my brow in, I'll start with the tail being a little more heavy-handed. And as I work my way up, I'm being a little more light-handed so that it can look like an ombre.
I was wondering when you were coming home. I haven't heard from you all day. So call me back, okay? Love you. Bye.
Okay, so right here is where I turn my brush and lightly dust my brow so that it creates that ombre effect. Now I'm blending with my spoolie, which is also important to get that ombre effect. Also, when I'm blending, I'm making sure that I blend in the direction of my hair growth. My old bitch lost the baby too. Ain't know what the fuck to do. Right before the first take, almost killed a nigga for some phones and quit this rapping just to buy your shit. Your niggas don't know this shit. Land over and spoken dip. Ain't even a half of it. Half a father, half a bitch, and half a break and half a bit. A hoe can take your for shit. And it's just an intro, nigga. I ain't even spazzing yet. Repeat the same steps for my other brow. Now it's okay that I'm kind of blending outside of my lines because I'm gonna go in and shape it up anyway.
Say they rap the best side.
Now this is just the clear brow gel from Anastasia that I'm going to set my brows with, making sure that I'm brushing in the direction of my hair growth. Then I go back in with the spoolie so that I can even the gel out. Alright, now this is my favorite part where we shape it up. I'm using a wipe. Most people you see use concealer, but I'm not wearing any of that and I rarely do. So wipes are my go-to. It's also better to have nails when you're shaping it like this so that you can have a sharp, clean look. Shaping the bottom of your brow can be a little more difficult because your skin is softer under there, so raising your brow may help. If you end up accidentally taking too much off, you can always go back and touch up. I love comparing because your eyebrows will look a little messy before you clean it up. Speeding it up, repeating the same steps. Now for my eyeliner, I'm using a brush that came with the Maybelline New York Eye Studio that I got from Walmart. I always start out with the tail. Then I go to the middle of my lid and work my way back to the tail. Most of the time, I won't do my whole lid because I hate getting eyeliner in my tear ducts. Then I'll go back to the tail and go a little higher if I need to.
Get game vision.
If you like it, fill it in. Repeat on the other side. Now for my dots, I'm using some liquid eyeliner I stole from my friend who stay leaving shit at my house. Some people think I'm weird for wearing dots, but it's like a signature thing I like to do. Finishing my eyes with my favorite mascara from Smashbox, Full Exposure. Using Fenty Beauty's matchstick and cinnamon, I'm highlighting my cheekbones. Sometimes I wipe some of the highlight on my nose. Next, I'm using a sugar scrub that I got from Lush, which is good to use before you apply matte lipstick. This is in mint chocolate. The good thing about using a sugar scrub is when you're done, you can just lick it off your lips. And don't act like you don't bite the skin off your lips anyway. Going in with some chapstick after I scrub. Next, I'm using my NYX lip liner in the color Espresso. And you can tell this is my favorite lip liner because it's so small. We will never die, real niggas, they multiply, yeah. If y'all don't know who Gold Link is, y'all sleep. Please YouTube him when this is over. Just speed it up real quick. I make sure that I blend with my lips. Next, using my matte lip paint from Tarte. And die, hell yeah. We will never die, hell yeah. blending with my lips again, and then I go back over it with my lip liner. Blending like this creates that ombre look. And that creates my look. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe.